Welcome to Ask Sveta episode. If you're new to this channel, this is the place where I can help you to resolve all your shoemaking problems. Your question must be very detailed and in video format or with pictures to get a good answer from me. Now, before we'll start, this channel is all about shoemaking, so make sure to subscribe to the channel and don't forget to click the bell button to know when my new video will come out. The first question that I got is from Elisa. Thank you, Elisa, for your question, because this is one of the most common problems, mistakes that beginners have in shoemaking, where during lasting they have a lot of folds in the back part of the upper. The solution to this problem is actually very easy, and later I will show you, Elisa, how to resolve this problem. But let's first see the question.
Hi, Sveta. Elisa from Melbourne, Australia here. My question is, when I'm lasting the heel, I tend to pull it tight, and then when I'm hammering it down, I have lots of folds, but the leather seems to stretch a lot more than what it does in your videos, and I have trouble putting enough nails in to stop the folds and stop any bunching. So I still have quite a few bunches around my edges. Is that to do with me using sheep leather, or am I cutting the pattern on the wrong angle? If you could give any suggestions, that would be great. Thank you.
So, Elisa, you have fold here in the back part, not because of the leather that you use that is too stretchy, like this one, but because of wrong pattern that you made. You probably have big pattern, and that's why you have folds in the back part of your shoes. Also, if the pattern is big, you may have too open neckline. So to resolve this issue, we have few ways. One of them, to reduce our pattern, and I start from reducing it on 2 millimeters from the back line, from the back seam that we have here. And actually, when you will reduce it on 2 millimeters from two sides of the pattern, we actually will reduce it on 4 millimeters, because it's 2 millimeters from each side. So simply use compasses and mark 2 millimeters, making line parallel to the back line in the distance of 2 millimeters. Then cut it out and you will have reduced pattern. If the opening of your throat line is fine, it's not too low, it lays perfectly, but you still have here folds, you will need to reduce it only in the bottom part of the pattern. To do so, you will need to reduce it starting from the middle of this line, back line, by making this line very smoothly until the bottom edge in the distance of same 2 millimeters or even more. 2 or 3 millimeters, make this line look like this. And in this way, you will reduce amount of the material in the back part and will leave the original fold line as it must be. Okay? So, try this method. Don't forget also to reduce the lining pattern as well, and you will have reduced pattern that will suit well, and you will have shoes without folds. The second question is from Michelle. Thank you, Michelle. Your question actually bothers a lot of people, and I think it's because there are a lot of information in the net how it should be, how it shouldn't. But here we are talking about classic shoemaking and how shoes must be made properly.
Do you need a steel shank in a 1 centimeter or 5 millimeters heel height shoe? And if not, should you still put an extra layer of the vegetable tanned leather insoles?
So this is steel shank that we use in insole making. I advise you, Michelle, to use steel shank always, no matter what heel height you will make, because the steel shank will give you good support to the body weight, to your arc zone, and you will have very strong shoes that will last for a long time. So when you will make insoles, use steel shank and place it between two layers of insole. And for the second layer, you can use or vegetable tan leather or shank board to have strong and good insoles for your shoes. That's it. Thank you for watching. Thank you for your questions. And if you are struggling with some very specific shoemaking problem, I am here to help you. Ask me it in video format or send me pictures with detailed explanation. The email to your questions you can find in the description below the video. Thank you again. Thank you for your questions. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click the bell button to be notified when my new video will come out. Thank you and see you in the next video. Bye.